Hey, I'm Haley. I live down the road.
I'm Mila.
You say you're what, like allergic to the world, right?
I guess you could say that.
We looked everywhere for a doctor. We looked everywhere for a doctor to help you.
You're gonna get better.
Promise?
Promise.
Hello, Eli. I'm Dr. Horn. I'm Dr. Horn.
Hello.
I hope you don't think of this as a medical facility. To me, it's a home. And for now, it's your home.
Oh, it's been so long.
Everything we hoped for is right here.
A clue which indicated his illness might have been caused by psychosomatic triggers and other internal factors. Very early on, we get an introduction to the recurring theme of deceit and lies, with every single person in the movie lying to the boy about what was happening to him, inflaming his paranoia and feelings of distrust as the narrative unfolded. This theme is introduced with a religious billboard the Millers pass on their way to the clinic, with a passage from Proverbs 19:9, which read, "The false witness shall not go unpunished, and he who tells lies shall perish." The only person that seems to believe him is a local girl called Haley, who befriends Eli through the glass of the conservatory window. Haley also fuels his suspicions about the place by telling him that she'd seen other children brought to the facility who never left, and that Dr. Horn was a shifty woman who didn't like her. The boy then soon realizes that the apparitions spooking him were the previous patients treated at Dr. Horn's clinic, and after they write the word lie on his window, the boy's suspicions about being deceived by his parents and Dr. Horn intensify. Horn also becomes creepier as he begins receiving the gene therapy treatments that made him appear to be getting worse, helped along by a phenomenal performance from Lily Taylor. During one particular episode, the ghost of one of the former patients scares Eli into the wardrobe and carves his name on the back over and over again. Though he insisted that something was after him, his parents and Dr. Horn refused to accept this, with Horn stating that none of her other patients had ever had visions of ghosts. But when he gets a different view of the writing, he realizes that the word wasn't Eli, but the numbers 317. It's here that we're treated to the unhappy dynamic of Rose and Paul's relationship, and the deep-seated mistrust between them, with Rose criticizing Paul's seeming indifference to the effect the treatment was having on their son. In response to this, Paul makes a snide remark about having always been faithful, alluding to the idea that she'd cheated on him in the past and that Eli wasn't even his son. Not only was this true, but we'd also find out that the true nature of Eli's condition was directly linked to this event. Prompted by his new friend Haley, who had a mysterious penchant for fiery magic tricks, Eli deduces that the numbers 317 must be the code to the medical wing. After entering the restricted area and going through the medical records, the boy discovers that all three previous patients had died after receiving the third treatment.
You're gonna get better.
Promise?